Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be testing out, demoing, comparing, and ultimately reviewing Morphe brushes. I have just under 40 brushes to get through and a sponge, so this is going to be a lengthy video, but I will be diving deep into every single brush, how I use it, how does it feel, is it worth the money, and comparing some of the brushes, because when I was choosing which ones I wanted to have, you know, some of them looked really similar and I had no idea what was the difference, and there is a difference between all the brushes, even the ones that look very similar. It's surprising, I know. I will be listing all of the brushes down in the description below in the order that I am reviewing them. So if you wanted to find something that will help you out, if you're just looking for like one or two brushes and don't want to listen to all of these brush reviews. But I'm having fun in this video. So if you want to have a little chatty fun time, then this is it. And I'm knocking something over already. We're off to a good start, everyone. So I guess without further ado, let's just jump right into this video. I am not sponsored, by the way. This is unaffiliated video with Morphe. I bought everything with my own money. This is my own opinion, as always, 100% honest. And if you do want a discount for anything, by the way, I don't have a discount, but if you Google online, there is going to be a bunch of discounts you can use. And if you're going to be buying something from them, make sure to use a discount code. Just a little thrifty side note. The reason I wore a red shirt today, by the way, is that I wanted to match the sponge. That's all you need to know about me. All right, so first things first, we're going to be testing out the latex-free sponge. Judging from the fact that it is spotless, that means I have not used it yet. So we're going to be testing it out for the first time together. Now, it looks quite interesting. It does have the very standard pointy rounded end here. And then on the other side, it's got this like flat double side edge situation going on. Now, as far as the feel of it, I will say that it is memory foamy, if you know what I mean. I'm a huge believer, lover, user of the Beauty Blender. It's very light, cloudy, very squishable, perfect kind of a texture. Every other sponge I've tried would be kind of like this, which is a little bit tougher and a little bit more firm. However, I do like that this is a little bit bigger than a regular Beauty Blender, so if you want to apply something really quickly, you can do it with this one right here. It is tougher, so it feels like a massage a little bit. I will kind of have to be honest and say that I'm not the most neat, most gentle applier. I know some girls are very like that, and I'm like, get on foundation, no time to waste, you know? So there's that. So anyway, this sponge is worth a try if you don't already have something that you enjoy, but if you do, you can stick with that. I wouldn't say this is absolutely revolutionary, but I will say that I do like that because this is a little bit tougher than the Beauty Blender, I feel like the foundation went on a little bit more compact and looks a little bit more natural even. There's just something about that extra pressure that almost melts the foundation into the skin. But I also will say that this is very similar to a lot of other sponges I have, at least as far as the way it feels. If you already have something and you like it, you can probably just stick with that. But if you want something like this, if you especially like the shape, if for some reason this calls out to you, like this bit right here, then you can definitely give this a try. I think you would like it. And I will say that I think, you know, for the price and the finish, it's worth looking into. I still like the way the Beauty Blender feels though. Okay, I'm gonna move on to the M439. This is a buffing brush, which I've already used a little bit, so we're just gonna look past that. Some of these brushes I've already used and I did not wash them before this video. I do support and personally wash my brushes often, because if you don't, then they get gross and you transfer bacteria and you have acne. So you wanna make sure you do that, but I don't wash my brushes after every single use. So, okay, now that we got that covered. This is a very soft, slightly rounded edge brush, and I'm not a huge foundation brush applicator person, partly because I find that if I have dry skin or any roughness, the brush just agitates that. Because there's so many bristles and they are quite short, they will be, I feel like I said short funny, sorry. The bristles will be a little bit more intense when it comes to buffing and blending. Again, if you have any kind of issues with dryness, I would probably stick with the sponge, any sponge, as opposed to a brush. My foundation might be a little bit lighter than my skin. Not too much lighter this time. If you watched one of my recent foundation reviews, you know that this is much more matchy-matchy to my neck. That one was quite pale. Anyway, so this is the sponge, and then this is the brush. both did a great job. Again, I'm personally much more of a sponge foundation applicator kind of person. I'm gravitating towards sponges as opposed to brushes. And I actually have a couple of brushes like this. I have a Sigma brush. I have a couple of like Amazon ones. They're all really, really good. You don't have to buy this particular one, but if you want a good one, this is definitely one of the better ones. Even like looking side by side, and I'm not sure if you're seeing that on camera, this side looks and feels a little bit more hydrated, even though I didn't apply anything underneath. And if I did do something, it's to both sides of my face. This side just feels a little bit drier. And again, I think it's because it's almost exfoliating my skin, but at the wrong time, because I don't want it to be like exfoliating and applying makeup at the same time. So I like to stick with with a good old sponge. Okay, the next brush I'm gonna talk about, I'm not actually going to use, but I'm gonna kind of explain to you how it performs and what I would use it for, because I have used it in the past. And it's the E1 brush. First, let me tell you a quick story. The first brush I got was broken. The actual brush is fine, but the part, the metal part and like the handle, they're loose and I couldn't pull it out and put glue in there. So I tried to put glue, I couldn't fix it. I ended up contacting them and explained the situation, sent them a photo, and they were so, so nice and sent me a brand new one that was perfectly fine. So really good customer service on that part. This brush is quite heavy. It's a really dense, massive, heavy brush. Online it says it's good for powder. It probably is good for powder because it's very buffing and you can get a lot of product on 1,000,002 bristles that this brush has. But what I think it's even better for is body application of makeup, specifically bronzer or fake tan. I actually did use this for both bronzer and fake tan previously and it worked really, really well. Now you don't have to use a brush for applying fake tan. If you use a mitt, that may be your preferred way of applying fake tan on your body. But if you need a really good brush for that kind of a deal, then this is a good one to check out. So anyway, this is a great brush to have for that, and again, thumbs up on their customer service. Okay, next one I am actually going to use, but right after I apply some concealer underneath my eyes. If aliens ever came down and saw what I was doing, I think they would turn right around. Next, we're going to be talking about the E48 brush. Again, this is also used because I use it and love it all the time, and it's getting dust everywhere, sorry. This is an awesome brush to have for applying powder in small areas, especially underneath the eyes or around the nose. I wouldn't necessarily use this to apply powder all over the face, but it's perfect for those small areas. And I personally use two types of powder brushes, even like if I'm doing my makeup quickly, because I want something small around the eyes and around the nose, and then everywhere else I would use a bigger brush, which I'll show you in a second. And it's again perfect for applying powder in just so many different areas, but specifically smaller ones that have like nooks and crannies and crevices. So I'm going to uncrease my concealer real quick and just show you how good it works. Take some powder on there, and you see how it's like the perfect size, the perfect shape. It goes all around the eye and it's not like stabbing anything. It's got a nice domed cascading bristle formation. I'm gonna have trouble like describing the shapes here, but powder gets all on the edges there and then you can easily transfer it. And it does a phenomenal job of applying powder there perfectly. Okay, so E48, great one to have. I actually have some similar ones to this one, but what I like about this specific one as opposed to some other ones I have is that it's a little bit fuller and it's round, and it just makes it a little bit easier, a little bit more intuitive to have the shape as opposed to some other shapes that other makeup companies produce for this type of a brush, because this is a popular type of brush to have, but I think this is one of my favorite ones. Okay, next we're going to, again, one of my favorite brushes for Morphe, and it is a ginormous one. I use this all the time. You'll probably see it in my videos. This is a huge, huge, huge E41 large size dome powder brush. I love this because it takes a lot of powder on, and it's great for just blending and lightly applying powder in a large area. And it's not about being lazy or not wanting to use like a smaller brush, but it's also giving you a very even application because you're literally applying all of this at the same time instead of like taking this one right here and just like trying to stab your face a million times to try to apply that powder evenly. And sometimes you're gonna pick up more powder, sometimes you're gonna pick up less powder, and it's just not gonna be as even and as quick as something like this. But a lot of like companies produce powder brushes that look like this, for example. It's just not the same as this because, again, the smaller version of this kind of, it's round, so you can go all the way around and it's just much more intuitive and much easier to use. It's also great because it's domed, so you can get into, again, those like smaller areas of the face, like around your nose and all that stuff, and it is just absolutely perfect. It's going to take a while for you to get used to using this because it is just so much heavier than any other brush I have. These two, I mean, are massive, really heavy. As I'm doing this right now to smooth out some of the creasing that's happened since I was talking about all these brushes and didn't powder my face yet, if the foundation is looking a little bit rough and I need to pat it down or smooth some of the creasing, this is actually perfect to use for that. Okay, I'm going to take my ginormous powder brush and look how much product you're picking up. I just did it on kind of one side and you can just pat it this way. You can drag it too, but I don't like to drag my powder brush because then the foundation can sometimes like move and then the acne that I have underneath will show through. So that's just my technique, but you can totally do this as well. And it's just so freaking awesome and so quick. I love it. You can see how fast and quick this applies powder and it's amazing. I literally use this every single day. Now, just like with any other brush I'm going to be talking about, if you have something that you love and enjoy, then obviously use that. You don't have to go and buy any of these brushes. I'm just here to kind of share with you my favorite brushes and my thoughts on all of these brushes. So just a little thought. I honestly do use a lot of Morphe brushes on my face in my day-to-day routine because I bought all of these and, you know, a lot of them ended up being really, really good. So next I'm going to jump into using this brush right here, which is dirty, not dirty, but used, and it has makeup on it. And unfortunately, because of the color of the bristles, it's really gonna show, but this is what it looks like. It's not the softest brush, but this is a natural bristle hair brush, though they're not the most pleasant ones to use because it's not very soft. It is actually an amazing brush for applying the color but also diffusing it and making it look really, really beautiful and natural. This type of bristle is going to be shown through a bunch of different brushes throughout this video, and they're not the softest brushes. The softest ones are these ones, actually. They're the synthetic ones and they're really, really soft. Natural bristle brushes are great for powders because they have cuticles just like your normal hair does, and those cuticles grab on to the powder particles and deposit them and move them around really, really effectively. Synthetic brushes are great for not only powders but even more so for cream products because they don't have the cuticles that will then trap the cream products in them and just won't make the bristles work as well. So synthetics are great for creams, natural brushes are great for powders, but synthetics can be used for powders as well, and I obviously, this one is a synthetic one, use them and love them all the time, but that's just like the general division there. So I'm going to take my daily bronzer, my butter bronzer, which I love. This is my second package of it, and I'm going to take, again, the brush I use on a daily basis. As you can see, this is the M527, by the way, and I'm going to take some of the bronzer and I'm going to show you what I do with this. I love this shape because it is the perfect shape, perfect size, perfect density for applying the bronzer really, really lightly, but also enough so, and also blending it well with the rest of the makeup. It's a nice fanned out shape. It's pinched on one side, so you can do this, but you can also kind of go in circular motions, kind of like a buffing motion, because it has enough roundness to it, if that makes any sense, though it is more pinched on one side, which is great for this. It took me a little while to get used to it, especially with slight roughness of the bristles, but I think it looks very similar to one of the MAC brushes, which I never had because they're expensive, but that's exactly why Morphe brushes are great. They're almost like dupes of MAC brushes. But anyway, I love this brush. It is definitely worth checking out for sure. It's great for bronzer. Love it. The next brush is kind of like a catch-all brush. That's what it's described as. I got it because Jaclyn Hill was raving about it. So this is the R2. And it's a rose gold color. The rest of them are silver or chrome. It's a similar shape to this right here, but it's a totally different feel. This fans out a lot and the bristles are natural and kind of rougher. This one is a little bit more denser and it's also very soft and synthetic, and it also comes to a much more of like a defined edge. So when you're doing this, for example, you will get much more of like that precise line, and then the rest of the bristles will buff it out. I think that if you don't have something like this, it's great to have it because it is truly one of those brushes that can work in different ways. But I personally much prefer to have different types of brushes that are tailored to different applications because it just works better that way. Makeup's already hard enough, and having, you know, the best brush I think for the job makes all the sense in the world, especially when they're a little bit more affordable like these. So I'm going to just apply a little bit of bronzer with this one right here. It's also good for powder because you can do this with it. It's got that cascading bristle situation, so it's gonna catch kind of like this different shape, but kind of like this, it's going to catch all that powder and you can pat it. So if you want, you know, a little bit more of a precise and a little bit more intense application than this, then something like this could be what you're looking for. It's a good brush to have, but honestly, on a daily basis, I generally use this, especially because I tend to like over apply my bronzer and I feel like this just makes it easy not to. So that's just my personal opinion. So the next brush is also a natural hair bristle brush, and this is the M523. This is the same type of bristles as the other bronzer brush. It's almost like a similar shape to this, except it's smaller, it's denser, and it's a little bit more saturated. Like, it's gonna saturate the color a little bit more than this one right here. This one is softer, more flexible, fanned out more, so the color is gonna go a little bit softer and diffused. This one is gonna give you a much more precise, much more intensified application, but it's kind of like a similar feel. So what I would actually use this for is to touch up my bronzer or to add some contouring. I don't really wear contouring all too often, but if you do, or if I would, then I would use this right here because you can chisel your cheekbone so well with this back and forth, and it's the perfect shape because it's got that rounded corner, so you can go like this and it's not giving you any weird like shapes or edges or anything like that. I also love this shape for adding a little bit of bronzer around my hairline because I find that some of the lighter bronzer applicator brushes like this one here are great, but when it comes to making sure that the bronzer gets like up in the hairline so it doesn't look fake, they don't really do the best job. So I tend to then go back with something like this, something smaller and something a little bit more precise, and just kind of saturate the color. So this is again one of those brushes that are either very specific or kind of like a supplemental brush to some of your other ones, but it's a great one to have for sure. These brushes, you have to find the right way to use them, and if you do, then you would love them because every single one has something amazing about it. It's just a matter of whether or not you will use it in the way it's supposed to be used, or if you can find, you know, a way to use it in your makeup routine, because if it's not something you would ever use, then obviously don't get it. Okay, so the next brush I have is the Morphe M572. This is a brush I got for nose contouring. Now, what I typically do for my nose bronzing contouring situation is I just take my good old bronzer brush and I go like this on the end of my nose because my nose is very bulbous and I just like to diminish this size right here. But I've been inspired by a lot of girls on YouTube who contour their nose and it looks absolutely beautiful. I'm still in the process of figuring out how I can do that and not look weird. But this is one of those brushes that can help you contour your nose. This is a very soft, let me see if it's a natural bristle or fake bristle because it could be either one, natural and synthetic. So it's both natural and synthetic bristle, which means it's soft, but it does have some of that roughness that will apply the product well and also kind of help to diffuse it. A couple times I've used it, I was very nervous because it's very flat and I didn't want to have like edges on my nose, so I'm just kind of gonna see what happens here. One side I'm gonna do with this brush and another side I have yet another nose contouring brush to test out. It's quite soft and it does have a good amount of bristles. This would actually not just be good for nose contouring but also for detail contouring. I mean like really detail, like I did right here for around the eyes right here, and also if you wanted to just kind of like chisel out or really like sharpen that edge, you can do that here as well. So it's actually a great one to have. Not a lot of you guys, I think, would use it on a daily basis per se, unless your makeup routine does revolve around, like, you know, specific nose contouring and that kind of thing. Maybe I'm just, you know, judging from my own routine because I don't really do that all too often. But if you do that, then this is great. On that note, we're gonna move on to another nose contouring brush. I actually thought this was an eyeshadow brush, and you can totally use that as that, but I think it's marketed as a nose contouring brush. This is the E62. Where are my notes for you? E62. Okay, so it's called Angled Nose Contouring Brush Synthetic Bristles. I'm gonna try to contour my nose on the other side, this side. This one is a lot firmer than the other one. This one is lighter and softer and feels like it has much more flex. This one is a lot more rigid. I honestly use this for eyeshadow application. Like, I would do kind of like this kind of thing. Because this is a little bit denser, it does hold its shape both the long way and the short way. I think I do remember using it right here when I would try to like add some shadows to my brows. This was quite nice to have because it was just the perfect shape and the perfect firmness of the bristles and everything. What I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to show you what I normally do with my nose contouring bronzing application, and that is I'm going to take a good old bronzing brush and I'm just going to lightly like add a little bit of the bronzer on the very tip of the nose. It's not anything precise here, I'm just basically trying to mimic natural sun falling down on my nose and then bronzing it or tanning it. I'm going to take my body bronzer and I'm just going to add it to my neck a little bit. Very soft, quite heavy, and it buffs the color really nicely. I would be careful to not use something really, really dark for the first time anyway, just so that you know how much it picks up and how it applies and deposits the color. But it does give you a really nice, like almost airbrush finish. But what I'm gonna do right now is I'm actually going to take this right here, which is E8, and I'm going to show you in a second how I would use this for blending out like cream products. I have a cream blush here. This is supposed to also be good for applying concealer around your eyes. I personally don't think I would use it for that. I would use it to buff something out if you need something kind of like small to be buffed out, because it's perfect. It's basically a miniature version of this right here, like much miniature, but still same concept. It's good for buffing things out. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you how I would use this for cream blush. I'm going to take a little bit on my hand, got a little spot right there, and I would start buffing this out. It's very, very soft. The bristles are very flexible. This is a great handy one to have, not for anything particular even, but just like to use it as supplemental kind of a brush for different applications as well as cream products. Now I'm going to jump to applying blush, finally. This is E3. And this is one of my favorite brushes from the collection, or from Morphe brand. Now, at first I didn't know what to use this for, and I think it's advertised as kind of like a powder slush blush, but I think it's perfect for blush application, especially if you're applying it in this area here. If you want to like mimic that natural skin flush, then this is perfect for that because it's got that beautiful shape where it can get in that area and apply it in just the right areas and make it look really, really natural. I like that it's round so you can go all the way around and you don't have to kind of worry about where that edge is and where the flat side is and where the flat side's not. So I like that a lot. I'm gonna take some of the color on. Again, it's got that cascading bristle formation, which is gonna pick up a good amount of color. And I'm just gonna start kind of like patting it on. If you apply a little bit on here, it's nice. Sometimes I apply a little bit up there. Sometimes I'm bringing it up in this area, and it just adds a little bit of color. Don't go overboard especially with some colors, because it can make you look really odd. Like if your face is just really, really red or something, you don't want that. But if you go with like lighter peachy colors or lighter pinky colors, those are really, really nice for this kind of application. Just makes you look quite youthful. Okay, oh, I might be going overboard. Now, I actually don't think I mentioned this brush right here, but this is a similar brush to the E48, which I use underneath my eyes, except this one is a flat side and it's a little bit bigger, and it's perfect for patting the powder on your face and having a little bit more precision than something like this. This is going to give you a very kind of like a swooping motion application. This right here is going to give you a very precise application, but unlike this right here, you can use this not just for detailing but also for all over the face, because the size here is a little bit bigger. The reason I'm bringing it up right now is that I'm going to take this brush and I'm actually just going to take some of the color off because I did go overboard just then, I think. Okay, on the other side, I'm going to take my E4 brush. This is an angled, either contouring, but I normally use these brushes for blush. So I'm going to take that and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to take my first blush color. With this brush, what you can do is you can either do this, or what I like to do is actually go like this, so that you're applying the color with that middle stiffer bristles, and then with the longer, softer bristles, you're then blending and dragging that color out. So it becomes a very like intense part of the application, and then that color gets dragged through the skin and it looks really, really nice. This gives you a little bit more of a precise application. This gives you a little bit more of, it buffs things out really nicely, but it also doesn't give you as much of control over where you're applying the blush. Now with this brush, you can apply your blush much better here. With the other brush, you can apply it much better in like in this middle part right here. So if you want to do kind of like of this look, then I would go for this brush. If you want to do the standard blush application more like in this area here and not bring it in as much, you can use this one right here. And as you can see, you can apply blush quite nicely with either of the two brushes. It's just a matter of what you will know how to use best, because honestly that's really where we're at. You just want to make sure that you pick the right tool that will work best for you, and for some of you guys this might be the perfect tool, and for others this might be the perfect tool, and for some maybe either of the two works great. So let me just compare these three brushes really quickly because I wanted to kind of explain which is which and give you a comparison, because they look kind of similar online but they really aren't in real life. Round, big, very, very tapered, very cascading bristles, picks up a good amount of product. Smaller, more round, flat on one side, great for powder all over the face or in smaller areas, but not as small as this, which is round all around, and it's tapered and it comes to kind of a point, perfect for underneath the eyes, around the nose. So that's the difference between them, and trust me, they are very different. They don't look it, but they feel it. Like, give you a little tiny sneak peek, these two are very different and they don't really look it, but they are very different and they feel very different. And yes, you can probably get away with just using one, but they feel much more different than they look. Like when you put one to the eye, you're like, all right, and put the other one, it's like, whoa, it's a different feel completely and different application, even though they seem quite similar. So just a little side note there. Time for highlighter, shall we? This right here, the Morphe M510 brush. This is supposed to be great for highlighting and a couple other things, but what I actually use this for is to sweep product from underneath the eyes, especially like eyeshadow or glitter or even extra highlighter. So you can use it like this as a highlighting brush. It's going to give you a nice buffing motion because though it's a natural bristle, very frayed out brush, it will give you a good amount of like saturation of the color. I don't use it like that. I think it's perfect for, again, just getting rid of the color because it picks up a good amount, like it just grabs on. The bristles are kind of like jaggedy and they grab on to all of the glitter underneath the eyes, and it's like the perfect shape for that. The brush I use for my highlighting, and I get a lot of questions asking which brush that is, and that is the M501. I actually have two because I bought it initially on its own from Ulta, and then I got a set. And this came in a set, so that's fine. So if you're like, why is one smaller than the other? That's because this one I've used for longer and it just ends up like fraying out like that. So it's gonna come in like a very precise, very kind of like together shape. And then after a while, it's gonna look a little bit more like this. Same with some other ones as well. Like this one right here, it comes in a little bit more compact and then it kind of frays out, but it's not a huge deal. Honestly, it does not take away from the quality and the application. So just keep that in mind with some of them, especially the natural bristle ones. Those ones like tend to like go like that. Okay, so I'm gonna take my highlighter brush, which I love because it's got that domed cascading perfect amount of bristles, perfect type of bristle. It grabs onto the product, grabs onto all the glitter and deposits it really nicely and also blends it out really nicely. I literally use this brush all the time. It's got a nice amount of area for the highlighter to be on the brush, and then it's also got a nice point so you can have a little bit more of a precise application but also a little bit more of like a bigger application. It's just a really, really perfect all around. You can honestly use this brush for nose highlighting if you use just the very, very tippy part of it. It's not going to be the most precise application, but it will be like small enough where you can use it as a noise highlighter. You can also add a little bit right there with the very, very tip of it, you know. So it's just a really awesome, versatile, all-around great highlighter brush. All for it. Another brush that's kind of similar is M438. It's similar but not. Again, online it looks much more similar to this one than it does in real life. It is, I believe it's a, okay, so it's a synthetic bristle brush. This is a natural one. You can actually kind of see it because this one, the bristles are very like not very straight and they're kind of like rougher. This one has straight, very smooth bristles. It's actually nicer feeling, but it doesn't grab on to all like the glitter and all the highlighter particles of powder highlighting as well as the natural bristle one does. But it's a lot more dense and a lot bigger, and it will give you a much more like intense application. This is also advertised as a great like contouring brush because you can use that like this and have a very like intense, very slim contouring application if you want to do that. I have a bunch of other contouring brushes I can use, but if you want something like this, it is bigger, it is softer, it will give you a very precise but also blended out application because it's got the bristles around the very tippy part, which is going to get the most color, and that's going to apply the most color, and the bristles around it is going to like blend that color out. Okay, the next one is this M310 fan brush. Now, I tend to gravitate towards using something like this for my highlighting, but this is a great versatile product to use if you want something that's very like soft and light, and it's a perfect shape for applying highlighter because it's, again, you can do this, you can do this, you can do right here, you can go sideways if you want to. So an awesome versatile highlighter brush. These two, I would think, for all over the face application are really, really nice. And if you want something, you know, a little bit more intense and precise, this is also a good option, but I save that for my cleanup mess situation brush. I'm going to finish highlighting my face everywhere but the nose, and the nose I'm going to save for later because I have an eyeshadow brush that I use for my nose highlighting if I want that like pop, that one little pop of highlighting. This is literally going to be the longest video I've ever filmed because I still have about 20 brushes to get through. Oh my goodness, you guys.